series of video lectures on pulse and digital circuits. So we are discussing chapter 1. The name of the chapter is linear wave shaping. Today in this chapter we will see the response of RC low pass circuit for square wave input. So that is our article today. First let us draw RC low pass circuit. As you know that the RC low pass circuit consisting of two elements, two passive elements, resistor and capacitor. Resistor and capacitor. So where we take the output voltage across capacitor. So this is called as RC low pass circuit, simple circuit. So this is the input to the circuit Vi of t. The current due to this input voltage is say I of t in this loop, where we take the voltage across capacitor, which is called as output voltage V0 of t. So let us assume that the voltage across resistor is say Vr and the voltage across capacitor is say Vc. Now for this low pass RC circuit we are applying a square wave input. Let us draw the square wave input. So as I explained the basic waveform of square wave input. So the square wave input will be like this. The square wave input will be like this. So let us assume that this is zero level. It maintains a level of, so this is Vi of t versus t. This maintains a level of V dash for a duration of t1, and it maintains a another voltage up V double dash for a duration of t2, and then it repeats the same waveform repeats with a time period of t. So if such a waveform is applied to this RC low pass circuit, what will be the response of this circuit? So under steady state condition, so I am drawing directly the waveform under steady state condition. Under steady state condition, that means after output waveform reached to steady state values, under steady state condition for RC greater than time period, or RC is very close to the time period of the input waveform. So the output waveform will draw like this. Say, first let us draw the zero voltage level, and first let us draw the square wave input with the dotted lines, the input square wave with the dotted lines. So this is the input waveform, dotted lines. Now so the output waveform will be something like this. So the output waveform, so something like this, the capacitor charging and the capacitor discharging, and capacitor charging and capacitor discharging. So this waveform, remember that this is output is steady state output. Steady state output. This is called as steady state output. We can see that it starts with a voltage of say at a voltage level of say V1 and charges to a voltage level of V2, and so the same cycle again it comes back to V1 and again charges to V2 and comes back to V1, something like that. The same pattern this waveform repeats for every cycle. So this is called as steady state value. That means the output waveform will settle down to these two values, V1, V2, like that the same waveform continues. So therefore we make small adjustments in this. So this voltage level, as I said, V dash input waveform. So this voltage level is say V double dash. So this time period, what is this time period? T1. So this time period is say T2. The total time period of this waveform is what? T. So what is the amplitude change here? Here I forgot the amplitude change between, the amplitude difference between V dash and V double dash is V. So let us note this same amplitude change in this waveform also. The amplitude change between V dash and V double dash is say capital V. Actually, the waveform starts at V1, it charges to a V2 voltage by the time T1. Actually, it has to reach to what value it has to reach to the final value? Actually, it has to reach to the V dash. Similarly, the discharging has to reach to V double dash, because this is the voltage level, V double dash, like that. So you make this, it has to reach to a final value of V dash, and this waveform, the red waveform, has to reach to a value of V double dash. Let us call this voltage diagram as V01. Let us call this diagram as V02. So let us call this waveform as V01. Let us call this waveform as V02. Now our objective is to derive the expression for voltage V2 and voltage expression for V1. So that is our objective. What are these steady state values? So that is what our objective is, to find out what is the value of V2 and what is the value of V1. So that is steady state value of this waveform. For this we use this formula. Use final initial final formula. I call this formula as final initial final, very very important formula. So the waveform V0 of t can be written as first final value Vf plus initial value Vi minus Vf into e power minus t by RC. We can use the same formula, remember that we can use the same formula for current also, for current waveform also we can use this very very important formula. We use several times this formula while solving the problems. So I0 of t is equal to If plus Ii minus Ie, If into e power minus t by RC. So for the waveform say, V01, how to write this expression? At t is equal to T1. So let us write this for first waveform V01. So that is the waveform name, V01. So at t is equal to T1, carefully write this equation. At t is equal to T1, so at t is equal to T1, you can clearly see that what is the output voltage it reached to? It reached to V2. So therefore this place we have to write V2. So that is equal, but Vf, but what final value it has to reach actually? So V dash. So therefore V dash, V final plus, carefully write, what is the initial value of this waveform? At which it is starting? It is starting at a voltage of V1. So therefore V1 minus the final value it has to reach to V dash into what is the time period? T1 by RC. Let us call this as equation 1. Let us call this as equation 1. Similarly, for waveform, so V02 at time t is equal to T2, apply the same formula. You can see this is the waveform V02. At t is equal to T2, what is the waveform value? V1. So that is what we write, V1. So that is equal to FIF formula. What is the final value it has to reach? The final value it has to reach to V double dash. So V double dash plus, what is the initial value of this waveform? The initial value of this waveform is V2. So we can see that the initial value of this waveform is V2. So V2 minus final value of this waveform it has to reach is V double dash into e power minus T2 by RC. Say this is equation 2. So we use equation 1. So what is our objective? I have said earlier, our objective is to derive the expression for the steady state values of the output waveform, that is V1 and V2. So now consider that for symmetrical square wave, input. So carefully, this is your input waveform. Let us say this is your input waveform with a zero average value. Let us say for symmetrical square wave, what are the conditions? Let us see. So this is V dash. So this is V double dash. So this is the amplitude change V. Peak to peak amplitude is V. So now this duration is say T1. Say this duration is say T2. The time period is say T. So what will become if it is a symmetrical square wave input? So V dash is equal to minus V double dash. So that is equal to V by 2. It will become, for example, if it is 2 volts, let us say, if it is 2 volts for symmetrical, for example, let it is 2 volts, so then it is minus 2 volts, that is V dash is equal to minus V double dash, and peak to peak what is 4 volts, that is V by 2, so that is what, this duration, T1 is equal to T2, that is equal to capital T by 2, so that is another condition, T1 is equal to T2 is equal to T by 2, so this is the first, you have to take these values very carefully. Now, for the output waveform, if you this kind of input is given to the circuit, low pass circuit, the output under steady state has, you can see in this diagram. So for such kind of input, for symmetrical square wave input, so these values V1 and V2 are equal with opposite sign. So we have to understand that, so for symmetrical square wave input, so the output waveform will reach a steady state values where these values V1 is equal to minus V2. So that is what we substitute here, or V2 is equal to minus V1. So therefore, under output and steady state has V2 is equal to minus V1. So these conditions we have to substitute in equation 1. So therefore, in equation 1, so what is our equation? So V2 is equal to, what is our V dash plus V1 minus V dash into e power minus T by T1, in fact T1 by RC. So this is our equation 1, I am rewriting this equation. So now let us make our assumptions. So V2 keep as is. What is V dash can be written as V by 2, what is what we have mentioned, plus V1, what is V1 is written as minus V2. So from the output waveform V1 is written as minus V2. So minus V dash is written as V by 2 into, since for symmetrical strand T1 is equal to T by 2, T by 2 RC. Let us simplify this equation, we will get the final answer. Let us simplify this equation, bring V2 term this side and take V by 2 as common. So bring V2 term this side, so therefore it will become, so V2 into 1 plus e power minus T by 2 RC. So that is equal to V by 2 into 1 minus e power minus T by 2 RC. So we want the expression for V2, so therefore V2 is written as, so V by 2 into 1 minus e power minus T by 2 RC divided by 1 plus e power T by 2 RC. So multiply numerator and denominator by e power T by 4 RC by e power T by 4 RC, both will cancel out. So multiply numerator by these terms, e power T by 4 RC. So therefore the V2 will become, what is V2? Steady state value of the output. So V by 2, so into e power T by 4 RC minus e power minus T by 4 RC by e power T by 4 RC plus e power minus T by 4 RC. So let x is equal to T by 4 RC. Let us call this as, let it, where capital T is the time period of the input waveform, RC is the time constant of our low pass circuit. So this equation V2 is written as, so V2 is written as V by 2 into, so what is the expression is written as e power x minus e power minus x by, so e power x plus e power minus x. So therefore, from what is this formula is written as, from the hyperbolic formulas, this is written as tan hx. Therefore, what we can write is, so V2 is equal to, very very important formula, we use this formula, V by 2 into tan hyperbolic x. We use this formula several times, so while solving the problems, where x is equal to t by 4 rc. So what is v1? So what is v1? v2 we have found. What is v1? So v1 is equal to minus v2, because for symmetrical square, remember that for symmetrical square wave input, so the output reaches to steady state values where v2 is always equal to minus v1. So this condition satisfies. So therefore, if you find v2, automatically v1 is nothing but as negative of v2. So this is the very, very important derivation for better understanding this output waveform. I have made one video about this, the response of RC low pass circuit with square wave input for different time constant. You can see that video in multisim software, where you can see this kind of waveform. On that waveform I have clearly mentioned how v1 is equal to minus v2 is coming in that waveform. Please watch that video also to better understand the derivation of this square wave input. Thank you.